Namaste. I want you to visualize a bullock cart being pulled by two bulls. For the bullock cart to progress steadily and forward, both the bullocks have to progress at the same speed. If one of the bullock goes fast, the other bullock either stays or is very slow, imagine what is likely to happen. Man being part of duality, good and bad, night and day, rich and poor, happy and sad. Anything that we do has two sides. And if both these sides are not balanced properly, taking the cart, which is like your life, towards the desired goal is not that easy. It can topple, it can change direction, it can fall, anything can happen. I will draw two parallels from this analogy of bullock cart in our lives. One is our material life, the other is our spiritual life. But in both these lives, one of the bull or the quality associated with the bull remains a constant. That is what I would call, that's what my Adi Guru, Sri Ramchandra Mission, Pujya Sri Lalaji Maharaj, called it as a clock. Let's imagine the material life first with the two bulls. One bull, which I said, is the character. The other bull is our success in material life. What happens to many of us in our urge to get more and more material riches, we drive that bull, which is the success bull, very, very fast, taking our focus off the other bull called as character or as a clock. Imagine what happens. Sometimes by the time we realize the importance of the other bull, we might even be 50, 60, 70 plus. Fortunate are those who realize it much faster. Imagine having a boss who is extremely successful but is very arrogant, very rough, very harsh, very aggressive, very abusive, emotionally unstable. Would you like to work under such a boss even if you are given a huge sum as salary? Maybe initially yes, but at some point of time you will say that I can't work under him anymore because he's not being human. We call it by different words, but finally it boils down to one single thing: the character of the concerned individual. Let's now flip it to the spiritual aspect of our life. Lalaji Maharaj is supposed to have said, I place morality, which is the next level, I would say, of character formation, the ultimate level. I place morality even higher than spirituality. The way in which material life we had two bulls, in spiritual life also we have two bulls and the cart. The cart is our life or our goal towards the ultimate, the highest spiritual progress that is possible for humans, thanks to our Guru. Assuming that the Guru keeps on giving you spiritual progress, and you are also doing your sadhana very well, that bull keeps running towards the destination very fast. But imagine what happens. The second bull hardly moves. If you are part of any spiritual system, as you progress through the various stages of spirituality, there are certain characters associated with such progress. if you are in heartfulness, if you are in the heart region consisting of the 5 points, each of the point has certain characters. Once you cross that and move to the mind region, each of the point again has lot of characters. And then it goes on till you reach the central region and the ultimate destination, the center. But if you are still exhibiting qualities which are not even worth of a person who has commenced his spiritual yatra, what use would that be if, even by the grace of the Master, you have been given the ultimate spiritual progress and approach? The cart will still fall. In all probabilities, in my personal understanding, this is purely my personal understanding, that your spiritual progress at the time of whenever the scores are settled will equal the character that you have formed or transformed into at the time of such evaluation. If your character is only at the level of say 0.1 or in 0.2, and the Guru has given you an approach say like 7th point, 8th point or 9th point, in all probabilities you may slip back and balance it out, because for both bulls have to be on same line for the cart to progress. Why so much emphasis on character? Because the Gurus can give you spiritual progress just like that. As Babaji Maharaj used to say, from here to here in no time. They are capable of giving you anything, but there is one thing they have put the complete onus on, the responsibility is on us, which is our character transformation. If you have been made a saint, if you have been given the ultimate spiritual progress, but you still behave as if you have not even commenced your spiritual yatra, full of rage, full of tamas and rajas qualities, what is likely to happen? This is precisely the reason, after you commence your spiritual practice in any sanstha, all the gurus will keep talking about character formation, character transformation. The same is true for material life. A leader who does not have a great character to talk about, who is not worth being followed, some point of time will fall. The same is true for the spiritual life as well. What does character take after all? To put it quite simply, character has two aspects. The first is attitude, the second is behavior. The behavior is what others see. The attitude is what I have inside of me. I can act outside to be of a good behavior, but may not have a matching attitude. It's up to me to change. When you have the inside and outside as the same, whatever Guru say you must have, your character formation is in place. And in all probabilities, you are likely to match the character that is required of your spiritual progress. Think about it. If you are given a choice between spirituality and morality, which one would you choose first? You might want to choose both and then work towards it. Leave the spiritual progress to the Guru. If you are dedicated in your practice, he will take care. I hope I have communicated the message that, as our Adi Guru says, morality is more important than spirituality. Think about it. Thank you.